welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. And Kim, we're going to finish up everything that you can possibly learn about Photoshop Elements.
We need to do about six shows just on this application, just because it's so much fun. And there's so many cool tools. We can't obviously get to all of them today. But you're going to show us a few more of our favorites here in the last segment.
Yeah, we've got a couple quick sections to go through. If you look at the top menu, remember we talked about the organizer.
Right.
Which is, you know, you can still get back to the organizer with this button in the upper right-hand corner. And we just did edit, but we're going to do some creating, a little bit of creative stuff. And you can make a photo book here, a photo calendar. I'd recommend you have at least 12 pictures open for that one.
Okay. Yeah. Why, Lee?
You can make a photo collage.
What if you like the same picture every month?
Okay, I guess that's a good point. And you can make a slideshow. So what I'm going to do real quick here is I've already got my pictures down here. If you look in the bottom
right. That area down the bottom is called the bin.
Mm-hmm. And I can move things around in here, too. If I want to move this picture back to the middle.
Right. Just, so you can organize them, pre-organize them, basically, down there and just kind of get them in the order that you want.
Yeah. And we've got some pictures here of our friends from Adobe.
Okay.
And a picture of kids at the basketball game, the bike, and then we're going to end up at the sunset. So I'm going to select all these. I'm going to shift-click.
Okay.
Selected a beginning one and an ending one. And we're going to do a photo collage. And I click on that, and I get all kinds of choices here.
Oh, I love choices.
I can do backgrounds.
There's one with the palm tree. Why don't we do that one since we're at Palm Breeze Cafe?
That sounds like a good idea.
All right. So, again, it gives you a little thumbnail.
Mm-hmm.
And then at the bottom, you also have a layout. So how do you want your pictures to appear? And once you've kind of got that done, it sort of kind of gives you a little idea what their finished product is going to look like, just with some boxes and things. And
it's going through all five of those pictures. And obviously, if you selected more, it would be doing all of those as well.
Right, right.
And look at that.
Wow. So when you click on it, now how do you get it to turn that page like that? That was cool.
That was cool, yeah.
Maybe down the bin, you've got them down. Oh, I see. Down the bin, you've got them.
Oh, yeah.
Down there.
There we go.
And then you
it made new pictures. Look at that.
Yeah, cool.
So I've got to go down here, page. And
neat.
That is neat, the way it turns that page.
It does. Now, you could share these out in different ways. There's a share tab up there that lets you take a photo collection like that,
a
photo collage
here.
That you've created, and you click on share. And it gives you some options to do it.
Yes.
You can send it to people by email. You can obviously, you're not going to be able to print it and get that cool little thing, but you're going to save it to a DVD and give it to somebody. Lots of ways that you can take your creations and then share them, because as much fun as it is to do it on your own computer, I want to, if I do something cool, I want everybody to see it.
And the online album thing lets you work with Photoshop.com online, and they give you 2 gigs of space free.
So
gigs is a lot for pictures.
It is a lot of pictures, right, exactly. And especially, again, if you're going through a program to prepare, then some of the optimization is done for you. You can actually get more space because it'll kind of compress those photos down into a format that lets you, more easily display them online.
Now, say I'm building an album to share online.
That's cool.
And I call it test, and I'm going to go, it's got Photoshop showcase. I could also export them to a CD or DVD, or export them to a website with FTP.
And again, isn't that cool? Down at the bottom, you see little thumbnails. You
can
scroll your mouse over the top of it and open different images.
So I can give it a title, subtitle, do the background. We're just going to get through here as quickly as we can.
Mm-hmm.
And it's preparing these files.
Right.
And when it's all said and done, it's going up to Adobe Photoshop online, Photoshop.com.
Right.
And it's going to let me publish them right up there. I'm not going to go through the whole publishing thing because
it
is a little time-consuming. Let you log in here and everything.
Right.
And basically, you can put everything right up there online.
Right.
Now, you do have to register for this once.
But it's the same registration that you use for all these other Adobe things like Buzzword and online and things like that. So if you've already created an account with Adobe, you just use the same one over again. Very cool.
Very easy to share. Very easy to edit. Absolutely amazing features in here. We're just barely scratching
the tip of this. I know. But imagine trying to do Photoshop in 30 minutes. We'd be stuck figuring out how to make the layers work by now.
And you can do layers in this, too.
Absolutely. So, you know, it has all the built-in tools that come with Photoshop. But basically what they've done is they've put it into a friendlier environment for the average person to use. So, you know, you don't have to learn all these things about correction layers and selection layers and all those kind of things that you might have to do in Photoshop. You can just click and drag your effects into place, or use a different brushes. Cool things like the healing brush. Let's say you want to kind of get somebody out of a picture.
I have used that healing brush. That is like magic.
It is. It's way cool. And of course, in the background, what's happening is the software is evaluating every single pixel. Every one of those little tiny dots that makes up a photograph is being examined by the software as it goes through and it does these kind of things. So really, really way cool.
They even call some of these things by their magic names because they've got the magic extractor.
Right.
All kinds of really neat things. Oh, you know, I forgot to show you the preferences thing. If I've got time to do that.
So under general preferences,
I'm going down to the partner services,
uh-huh.
And this is where you can turn off all those annoying things that come up. I don't want to hear about any of this stuff. I just turn it all off.
Right.
Checking for a certain, no, I don't even want that. I'm turning that off. I will no longer get that pop-up.
Okay.
So real easy to go through the preferences. Everything's very self-explanatory,
mm-hmm.
And I love the things it does. Another thing that we didn't get to do is we showed the red eye correction. It has a teeth whitening.
Oh, that's a new. Is that new in Photoshop 7?
That's brand new.
So you can actually, I think it has two settings. So you can like ultra whiten people's teeth and make them look like one of those scary TV people that you see that blind you when they smile on camera.
Yeah, so out of the Digital School Collection, that's the first one we're going to do.
Right.
Photoshop Elements. And
come back next week and we'll talk about Premiere Elements, and then we'll do Sound Booth the following week. So all these things from our friends at Adobe, Photoshop Elements, great product.
Yeah.
So many creative things you can do. So check it out and then come back and see us next week.